going to record. Excellent. So my name is Deborah Schenzer, and if you've met me before, I am the lead teacher for the online academy.
Tenemos a la maestra Deborah Schatzner.
Schenzer.
Es la que está encargada de la maestra, la cabeza de la maestra de la junta.
And we do have Mr. John O'Neill here today, and he is our program administrator.
Y tenemos también presente el administrador del programa, que se llama John O'Neill.
Okay. Okay, so the purpose of our meeting today is we wanted to address some major topics prior to conferences so that your conference time with your teacher can specifically focus on your child.
El presupuesto de esta reunión es para abordar los temas principales antes de las conferencias para que el tipo o el tema de las conferencias puedan centrarse específicamente en su hijo.
So the things that we're going to be talking about today is we're going to talk about us, which is who are the teachers and what subjects do they teach, our daily schedule, our expectations, how does grading work, our supplies in your work area, and at the end we'll have time for any questions.
Entonces, ¿cómo vamos a seguir la junta de hoy? Primero vamos a hablar sobre nosotros. Segundo, la agenda del día del diario. El tercero, lo que esperamos de su estudiante. El cuarto, sobre las calificaciones. El quinto, sobre sus materias útiles. Y el último, vamos a pedir si tienen preguntas para poder contestarles.
Okay. Thank you. So we have added to our staff for the grades 1 through 4, which we have been super excited about. We now have a teacher for each grade level, which is fantastic.
Entonces hemos agregado maestros a nuestra escuela. Entonces tenemos ahora un maestro para cada grado, que es algo muy emocionante.
And so I know that that's been a lot of changes. It's caused some changes in your teachers for your students. It's caused some schedule changes. And we really appreciate your flexibility and kind of hanging in there with us as we get this program off and running. But it just became so popular that we had to grow because we had more students coming.
Entonces, yo sé que hemos tenido muchos cambios últimamente, cambio con los estudiantes, con la escuela, con los horarios. Apreciamos mucho su presencia con nosotros, pero como el programa estaba creciendo, tuvimos que crecer nosotros también con agregar adicionales maestros.
So, at the first grade, we have Mrs. Bauer. Second grade is now Miss Alexander. Just joining us this week is Mr. Nims. He's doing our third grade, and Mrs. Braza is now doing just fourth grade.
Entonces, como tienen aquí presente, en el primer grado es la maestra, la señora Bauer. En el segundo grado, la maestra Miss Alexander se va a encargar solamente del segundo grado. Y tenemos en tercer grado, que acaba de llegar la semana anterior, Mr. Nims. Y en el cuarto grado va a ser la señora Miss Bazarra.
Braza. Excellent. So we do have, this is our general schedule, and I wanted to go over it again because this is really important for when your student starts their day, when they end their day online. But I also want to talk about this, what they're doing when they're not online. So for the grades 1 and 3, you start your day at 8 a.m. and they will have 1 hour of literacy block with their teacher. At 9 a.m., they have an hour of math. They have a 45-minute science. Then they have a reading intervention time where they're either getting help or they're working specifically with their teacher. And then these afternoon times, that is the time that they are working independently or what we call asynchronously. But this is when they're supposed to be doing their homework. So that's we're giving them time within the day to do their homework. But we also have these highlighted times when those teachers are online. So if your student needs help, they can join back in and get help.
Lo que tenemos aquí es la agenda del diario. Hay agenda, vamos a empezar con la agenda del grado de 1 al tercer grado. Lo que están viendo aquí, el primer horario de 8 a 9, va a ser 1 hora de bloque que tienen para la clase de leer. Luego lo que sigue es matemáticas. También va a ser 1 hora de 9 a 10. Enseguida va a ver que tenemos tenemos de 10:45 a 11:30. Lo que tenemos aquí es como una intervención para poder leer. Ahí es donde van a poder tomar tiempo de si hay algo que no hicieron anteriormente, que puedan tomar tiempo para arreglarlo allí. Más adelante va a ver que tenemos los bloques donde empieza de 2:30 en adelante. Eso lo que está viendo ahí es donde les va a dar tiempo específicamente para trabajar en las materias o tareas que no pudieron terminar. Pueden recibir ayuda con los maestros, etcétera.
Okay, and very similar for fourth grade, they just start an hour later. So their lit block starts at 9, then they have math at 10, their science is at 11, and then they have that intervention time, and then Ms. Braza is available 1:30 to 2 for any more help or Zoom meetings.
Igual en el grado que es 2 al 4 grado, es muy parecido a lo que dije anteriormente. Están viendo que ellos nada más entran una hora más tarde que los otros estudiantes, pero los bloques son similares. Lo que tienen para leer es una hora, matemáticas una hora, nada más que empiezan a las 9 en vez de los otros que empiezan a las 9. Igual tienen su clase de salud, matemáticas, 11:45 es cuando empieza el bloque donde tienen intervención, donde pueden terminar más tareas. Y más después del lunch va a ver los horarios, que ahí tiene específico horario para poder trabajar en otras materias que siguen adelante.
Okay, and we'll talk a little bit more about the schedule when we come back to the next slide. So again, our expectations that we're talking about is we're asking the students have their cameras on during the direct instruction. That ensures our active participation in class. Video cameras need to be on when students are visible. One of the things that we're asking is if that is a problem or you're having technical issues, to please have your student reach out to the teacher or have them communicate in the chat box with their teacher. But we're really trying to make sure that they are actively participating in class and doing what we're doing.
Entonces, una de las primeras cosas que tenemos aquí es que tienen que tener la cámara encendida. Durante la instrucción directa que tienen, quieren asegurarse la participación más que nada, que esté activa en la clase. La cámara de video debe de estar encendida con los estudiantes, que deben de estar visibles a los maestros.
The next one is work completion. Students will be assigned daily work and there will be some time in class to work, but any work that is not completed, they're supposed to do during that homework time. And that's where we're seeing some issues, is that some of our students are having a struggle with the work completion. So please make sure you check in with your teacher to make sure that's not an issue for your child.
Entonces, lo que sigue aquí es lo que es de terminar su trabajo. Entonces, dice aquí que los estudiantes van a estar asignados trabajos o materias al diario. En el salón van a tener tiempo para terminar estos trabajos. Pero si en caso ellos llegan a no poder terminar lo que tienen asignados, van a tener tiempo para poder llevárselo en casa y ahora va a ser tarea. Si hay algún problema, están batallando con una materia, por favor, no duden de pedir ayuda al maestro.
And then again, that also goes towards when they're completing that's demonstrate progress, which is students must show an ongoing progress in math literacy, science, social studies, and in their PE time. So that means that they're showing that progress, that they're attending, that they're doing their work, and that they're growing.
Igual también nos fijamos en que demuestran su progreso, que el estudiante debe demostrar un progreso continuo en matemáticas, ciencia, lo que es educación física, en lo que es leer y estudios sociales.
And this last one, attendance, that regular attendance is required. If you're going to be logging on late, teachers will be marking them tardy. If your child will not be attending because they're sick or you have an appointment, please still be sure to communicate with that teacher so we can get you an unexcused absence. One of the things that we have been running into is that we have some of the students are getting savvy enough that they can log in and then they kind of mute their teacher and turn off their screen, then walk away. And that's not attending. We're being ghosted a little bit. So we're hoping that we can make sure that we're doing regular attendance. We are taking attendance daily. It is being marked and it is being counted this year. I know last year was a little different, but this year it's regular school, regular attendance requirements.
Entonces quiero también terminar con lo que es asistencia a la escuela o en la clase. Regularmente, al diario, vamos a estar revisando su asistencia, que es un requerimiento. Con muchos de los estudiantes, cuando llegan tarde a clase, cuando se inscriben en línea, van a estar marcados que sí están en clase, pero que han llegado tarde. Si su estudiante, por alguna razón, no va a asistir o tiene una excusa porque llegar tarde, por favor comuníquese con eso, con el maestro. Ha tenido muchas experiencias que los estudiantes han aprendido muy inteligentemente cómo encender la computadora, poner el maestro lo que es en silencio y apagar su cámara y luego se van del salón de la computadora. Con eso piensan que el maestro lo va a marcar que sí asistió, pero eso no es la situación. Si el estudiante hace eso, nos van a marcar ausentes.
So this comes back to the grades, that the showing progress. So one, you can become an observer on your child's Canvas page. On their Canvas page, you can see your child's daily work, if they're missing work or missing assignments, and their scores for their completed work. And I'll let you do that part.
Entonces vamos a lo que es los grados. Ustedes pueden hacer parte de lo que le dicen un observador en lo que es la hoja de su estudiante, que se llama Canvas Page. Aquí pueden seleccionar para ver si las direcciones, cómo llegar a esta página. En esa página ustedes pueden ver al diario las materias que le dejan a su estudiante, las materias que les faltan por hacer y el puntuaje que les dan en esa materia de la clase.
Okay. And then report cards are done at the end of each term for grades 1 through 4. So that's about December 3rd, I believe, is when you'll get the report cards. And so that goes out. And what that's, it's not your traditional A, B, C, D. And you guys have probably, because you're already at that level, have seen those before. But it isn't an indicator of how the students are progressing towards the standards. One of the teachers was asking me to emphasize that part, because if, when you look at your Canvas page, if you see that your child has missed a lot of work, we have nothing to show their progress towards their standard. And so that's one of those things, like doing the daily work is really important, because that shows us how your child is progressing.
Entonces, algo importante que tenemos, que son lo que es la carta que mandan con las calificaciones, será alrededor como diciembre 4. No va a ser una carta tradicional con los grados de A, B, C, D, ¿no? Pero dice aquí que es un indicador para demostrarles en qué manera su estudiante va a estar progresando. Entonces, si ustedes entran a esta página y ven que falta mucha materia, ellos no pueden basarse en qué tanto ha progresado su estudiante si les falta esa materia. Es por eso que estamos haciendo los trabajos en clase al diario todos los días, para poder regular y ver qué tan están progresando.
Next, supplies and a place to work. So students should have received the following items, a Chromebook and a charger. So hopefully your child at this point does have their Chromebook and charger. If you're having technical issues with that, you guys can reach out to your teacher, or they can actually, they can give you an email address to send your questions to for help with your device. Grades 1 and 2 received a binder with literacy packets and their Go Math booklets. Grades 3 and 4 received a binder with their Avid notes for math. They should have the basics, like composition book, pencils, colored pencils or crayons, eraser, pencil sharpener, glue. That's their basic supplies. If you did not get any of that, I know third grade, we're still working on some things, but if you did not get any supplies, please make sure you contact your teacher and they will get that for you. And they will be doing supply pickup during conference week, which is next week.
Entonces, aquí lo que tenemos es las materias y lugar de donde va a trabajar su niño en el salón. Una de las cosas que está incluido, que ya han de de seguro que ya lo recibieron, es su computadora con un cargador. Si por alguna razón no han recibido eso o han tenido problemas técnicas, pueden comunicarse con la maestra. También hay un correo electrónico que también pueden comunicarse por medio de ese correo para, por si tienen problemas técnicas. Entonces, del grado 1 a 2 les han dado una libreta, lo que es un paquete de lo que es leer y otro paquete de matemáticas. Lo que es del grado 3 a 4 también les dieron un cuaderno o una libreta que tiene todas las notas, lo que es de matemáticas, con Avid. También incluyendo libretas normales, lápices, colores, crayolas, sacapuntas, resistol, y un borrador.
And the last thing that we've really need work, we talked about, was to have a quiet environment to work and a safe place to keep their supplies. I know that one of the grades is working on getting noise canceling headphones so that your kiddo can be more focused in and not be distracted by sounds in the house. But if they could have a quiet place to work and a safe place to keep all their supplies that's near their Chromebook.
Entonces, algo muy importante es que nosotros nos gusta que tengan un lugar donde está sin ruido para que puedan tomar el tiempo en trabajar, en hacer su materia, enfocarse sin estar distraídos con otras cosas.
Okay. And one of the things that we talk about, what sets us apart, what we're working towards to have us be set apart from other online options, is we do have that flexible independent work time, but that time does have to be used. We have daily live teaching and access to one-on-one help with the teacher. So that's their daily during the schedule, and they have the hot pink highlighted areas or hot purple or green, whatever the colors they chose. Then they have that time of their direct instruction, but they also have the ability to get one-on-one help with their teacher. They do, if you so wish, and I hadn't had a lot of people reach out for this yet, but if you want, they have the ability to attend in-person PE and music from their neighborhood school. And they do, we are offering the opportunity for children to be challenged and to help them make growth.
Entonces, parte de esto es que tenemos unas sesiones donde somos independientemente flexible para que cada estudiante pueda tener tiempo para trabajar en su materia. Al diario hay un maestro que les puede ayudar uno a uno. También tenemos la habilidad de, si quieren asistir en persona, la clase de educación física o música, si usted lo requiere. Otra oportunidad es que tenemos aquí muchas habilidades para que ellos tengan espacio para crecer.
Okay. And then the last part is, I wanted to have the opportunity, if you had any questions about our schedule, how we're running our days, what attendance looks like, if you have any questions on any of that, you can either put that in the chat box or you can feel free to unmute yourself and ask to anyone who has questions.
Cualquier persona en este momento puede hacer sus preguntas o lo pueden escribir lo que es en el chat, en el mensajero, y les podemos responder.
Give everyone just a second if they're typing.
So if they're typing, I don't see it, I'm assuming.
I can make it to, they should be able to open to everyone.
Okay, my chat says,
is just let me open that then.
Direct message to you.
Everyone. Okay, maybe her teacher at reading another one. So this one's asking the question, it may be for the teacher, but the reading morning time, is that just assigned reading? It could be their assigned reading, or it could be that they want them to do silent reading. So that would be more for the teacher. Sorry, my phone was ringing. But yeah, that we do check with the teacher on that.
Dice que eso lo que es asignado, lo que es de leer, debería de revisar con el maestro o la maestra.
Literacy intervention is for when we have students who are having struggles with reading. Their teacher may invite them in to a specific time that they're working with them on helping them with their reading skills to help catch them up.
Dice que lo que es intervención de leer es una sección que tienen cuando el niño o la niña está batallando en leer, tienen chance de poder recibir la ayuda para que ellos puedan alcanzar al nivel de los más.
And that's a good question. How do our children show ongoing progress in PE when it's done independently? It's the that will be the continually, like doing it on a regular basis. It's going to be their act, their participation.
Dijo que esa es una buena pregunta, que cómo pueden demostrar el progreso en adelante. Could you answer that for me again?
I basically said it's just their participation, their ongoing participation in PE.
El progreso en lo que es educación física, dice ella, lo más importante que nada es que ellos estén participando. Esa es una manera que ellos pueden ver que hay progreso.
So if your child so the question is, if we're playing a sport or going swimming, does that count? Yes, if you have a child who goes swimming every day or has those activities, they can log that in their PE log, and that does count as part of their activity that they can that you can count. We do have it's 150 minutes a week of PE that is required, correct, Mr. O'Neill? It's 150 minutes a week. And so they should be logging 150 minutes a week. That's about 30 minutes a day.
Entonces la pregunta fue que si mi hijo o hija está trabajando haciendo un deporte fuera de la escuela, si eso cuenta sobre los minutos de la educación física. La señora contestó que sí. Mientras ustedes meten esa información en lo que es su sección de educación física, ahorita tenemos 150 minutos a la semana. Eso viene siendo 30 minutos al día.
And then the question came in, where are we supposed to be logging these at? Each teacher on their Canvas page has a PE button. And when they click that PE button, it takes them to a Google form that they fill out with their name, they fill out with the activity they did, and how many minutes they did that activity. And that gets reported to the teacher. So they should have a PE button on their Canvas page that they can log that.
Una de las preguntas fue que cómo podemos registrar o poner la información de lo que es la educación física, el horario que hemos hecho. Entonces dijo que en su página, donde dice que se llama el Canvas, ahí va a encontrar un botón que dice educación física o PE, que es la PE. Ahí va a seleccionar ese botón y de allí la va a llevar a una forma que la lleva al programa de Google, y ahí va a llenar la forma con todas las respuestas que le corresponden.
Good questions. Anybody else have a question?
Hi, I'm Angela. I'm sorry I got on here late. The form of enrollment came up first, so I filled that out. I clicked the wrong link, I guess. But anyways, the PE form, when Asher first started school, I thought I was filling it out every day, but I did something wrong. Oh. When I put 30 minutes and I would put a dot behind it, then it wasn't submitted.
No, it won't. It's just the numbers.
Yeah, so I figured that out like a week ago. And so I just went back and told her he does go outside. He has a play structure with swings and a slide and a rock wall and a trampoline out back and a bike. And him and his sister go out every day. So I just kind of wrote that down and then start logging after that. Is that all right?
Yep, just communicate that to the teacher and that will be fine.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. And then Erica, I'd like to clarify on your question. Where is all the information for these additional activities being conveyed at? So do you mean where is it being stored for the teacher?
I've never even, we don't even record their PE because if it's not being like, I'm not going to rely on the kids, obviously, to just do whatever they want.
Right.
So if I don't see it, I haven't recorded their PE one time, but we make them do it every day. So when we're in the middle of like transitioning kind of with their dad and stuff like that. So I just need to, I guess go in and play around with their, whatever it's called, the
Canvas page.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because so
here's the deal is only some stuff is getting conveyed over. Right. And then if I reply to like the remind, sometimes I don't get a response or whatever. So I just want to know very clear and concise, where exactly are we to find this information at? And like, if I have a question, who answers the question?
Awesome. So technically your child's classroom teacher should be able to answer that question. So I don't know what grade, but if you email the teacher, I know that with third grade to fourth grade, there's been some, and then the first and second, there's been some transition of remind going from the original teacher to the new teacher. So there may have been some messages that got missed, but if you are like on Canvas, if there's the PE button, that's how PE is being recorded. And then it's all done digitally. And then it goes on to this teacher's Google page. They have a Google that file that they store all of that stuff on. So if you have a question about that, you can always email their classroom teacher. And if that doesn't get you an answer, you can always email me and I will find out. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, that works. Thank you.
Awesome. And I will just in the chat box, I will put my email address if anybody needs it. And I'm really good at responding.
I'll interpret real quick.
Thank you. Sorry.
Oh, it's fine. Entonces, lo que estaban haciendo unas preguntas, las preguntas siguen haciendo sobre la clase de educación física. Una señora había preguntado que llegó tarde, que la disculparan, que cuando ella estaba anotando el tiempo de la educación física, la forma, ella puso un 30 y un punto al final del 30. Y el hecho de que puso el punto causó que la forma de Google no aceptó los minutos. Parecía como que si nunca había hecho nada. Entonces quería que supieran que nada más tengan que poner los números. Si llega a tener un problema y si estaba haciendo su educación física y por alguna razón no pudo hacer nada, puede hablar con la maestra y explicarle que si está haciendo su trabajo afuera, su actividad, pero por alguna razón ha tenido un poco de dificultad. Luego la siguiente pregunta fue nuevamente que dónde se va esta información, que cómo llegan a ver esta información. Todo es digitalmente. Cuando ustedes presionan el botón en Canvas, que esa página es el principal para poder llegar a todas sus clases, allí va a ver que digitalmente lo están grabando y luego se le va, todo le llega a la maestra o maestro.
Excellent. Thank you. So another question came in about if you were deciding to put your children back into in-person, you would return to your neighborhood school. And we are going to be not quite yet, but we're in the next, probably like the next 3-4 weeks, probably, Mr. Ono, we're going to be sending out information about if making a decision, if you're going to continue with us the next term for another term and online, or if you would like to return to your neighborhood school live in person. So that information will be coming back, but you would return to your original neighborhood school. We know it was a little confusing with you guys being digitally housed at Harvey Clark, and we've been working on the communication to make sure you are still getting the communication from your original neighborhood school. But you will go back to your neighborhood school. It's a long way of answering that.
Una de las preguntas fue que qué pasaría cuando regresamos en persona a la escuela. Entonces su respuesta fue de que cuando llega a ser ese tiempo o si usted decide en cualquier momento regresar a la escuela en persona, va a regresar a la escuela que le toca de su vecindario, lo que es donde usted vive, cada zona tiene su escuela, ¿verdad? Dice que alrededor, a lo mejor en 3 a 4 semanas, les van a llegar una carta nuevamente preguntándoles si quieren seguir en línea o si van a tomar la decisión de regresar a la escuela en persona. Dice que entiende que ahorita hay un poco de confusión de esas cosas, pero ellos están tratando de poder informar y ser mejor en comunicarse con los papás. Entonces esperan una carta dentro de un mes.
Those are really good questions. Thank you for asking those clarifying questions. Do we have any more clarifying questions?
¿Cualquier otra pregunta?
Hello, I'm Angela again. So you're going to have this all year long, and if COVID is still going next year, will you still be doing this?
Yes. I'm like, well, you know, I'm looking at Mr. O'Neill. Yes, our plan is to continue in the next year.
Thank you.
Yes.
La pregunta fue que si seguíamos con la pandemia, si el año que viene íbamos a seguir, el año escolar que viene íbamos a seguir en línea. Por supuesto que vamos a seguir adelante, sumando que las cosas siguieran igual, no, si vamos a seguir con la escuela en línea.
So just to recap, and if you have more questions, feel free to interrupt me. Just to recap, the big things that we wanted you to get from today was just making sure that you knew who your teachers were and that you can kind of put a face to the name of, and you probably already heard their voices if you've been at home with your kiddos. You've heard them. And again, Mr. Nims just started this week and he's really excited to be joining our team for third grade. Their daily schedule, again, that orange and purple and green time, those times right there for all the grade levels, that is when they are live in person with their teacher, where they are actively being taught and with direct instruction. And our expectations, again, the big one here is attendance. Please make sure that if you are going to be absent for the day, let your teacher know so we can get that marked as excused for you. And if you need help on being an observer on your child's Canvas page, we do have directions that we can send to you. Just ask your teacher, they have these. And then the one here on supplies, we are doing supply pickup, so be watching for emails from your teacher. A quiet environment, safe place to keep their supplies would be great. And that's our big like ahas from this, the attendance and their schedule.
Entonces, para sumar más o menos lo que se trataba toda la junta, lo más importante que quería que supieran es conocer los maestros, tener una idea, ver su foto. Yo creo que ya han escuchado sus voces varias veces, pero ahora ya pueden ver cómo es el maestro. Lo siguiente era la agenda. Así se dio cuenta que en la agenda había partes que estaban en naranja, morado y verde. Esas áreas están pintadas en ese color para que sepan que eso es cuando están enseñando la clase en vivo. Es cuando la maestra está presente y el estudiante tiene que estar presente. Una de las, lo que esperan más que nada, que es muy importante, es la asistencia. Otras veces la asistencia no era parte de la calificación. Este año escolar sí es parte es una calificación adicional, la asistencia. Acuérdense que si tienen problemas a llegar a la página de Canvas, que le llaman, no dudan de pedir ayuda a la maestra o la maestra, y también les pueden mandar por correo electrónico instrucciones cómo poder llegar a su Canvas. Y lo finalmente es lo más importante, es tratar de que tengan ellos un hogar, un espacio donde se pueden concentrar, que no se van a distraer y que tengan todos sus útiles o materias para proseguir adelante en su día escolar.
And we did have one more question in the chat box about music, and is music a requirement? And as of right now, it's not a requirement. Is that correct, Mr. O'Neill? Yeah, music is not a requirement from the state. So if you want ideas about what your kiddo can do for music because they love music, each of our individual teachers have ideas for you. Like one of them was, she has kids who they had a keyboard at home and they're on YouTube getting free piano lessons on YouTube that walks them through doing something like that. So you can always, if that's something you're interested in, each of those teachers have ideas of things that you can do for music for your kiddos.
Entonces, una de las preguntas fue que si la clase de música era un requerimiento. Dijo que no, el estado no está requiriendo que tengan clase de música, pero si a ustedes les gusta mucho, su estudiante le gusta mucho lo que es la música, los maestros tienen muchas ideas de cómo pueden llegar a lograr eso. Una de las ideas dijo que si un estudiante, por ejemplo, tenía un teclado en su casa de música y aprendieron cómo tocar su teclado por medio de la página de YouTube. Esa es una opción, hay muchas opciones. Se pueden comunicar con el maestro o maestra y ellos le pueden dar otras ideas.
Thank you. Any other questions or you might have?
¿Cualquier otra pregunta?
No. Well, again, thank you so much for showing up today and listening to the presentation. And thank you for choosing the Force Grow Online Academy. This is something that we are looking at growing, and we have been so just amazed at how much we've grown this year. And we, again, appreciate your flexibility and your willingness to stick with us and continue to grow with us as well. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me and let me know. Do you have another question? Yeah, Lori. Right?
Okay, sorry. It's like, instead of typing it out, I thought I'd just ask. I'm curious as to when my student's teacher went from having two grades to just one, how big was that impact in that 2-week period of I'm just curious, like, was it a huge amount of people? We've been online the whole time, so mm-hmm. those that were coming in that first 2 weeks where they were like, wow, we have to separate, which was very smart, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was genius. And I knew it was coming too, but I'm just wondering how many you got flooded with, just out of curiosity. That was it overwhelming, or was it just kind of enough to kind of give each teacher their own, you know, their own class?
I mean, in my perspective, I would say overwhelming. from a teacher perspective, I believe we were like either we either doubled or almost tripled our numbers in the first 2 weeks from where we originally thought we were going to be. Yeah. John.
So, yeah, I'm just looking at the numbers on my whiteboard in my office right now. We were, you know, initially thinking, you know, like grades 1-2 blended, as you know, 2-3 or 3-4 blended. No, we're at 175 students just with grades 1-6. And we have 21 first graders, 26 second graders, 22 third graders, 28 fourth graders, 33 fifth graders, and 45 sixth graders. So like Deb mentioned, we're going to be sending out parent surveys to see how we're doing and suggestions for improvement. And then also, like we said, you know, are any parents planning to make the transition to in-person at the trimester, you know, back to their neighborhood schools? How many want to stay, you know, at least for second semester for grades 1-4? And then we will plan accordingly. So we are very excited by the turnout. And sorry, it caught us off guard because a lot of parents waited towards, you know, right before school started or the first 3 weeks of school. And Deb and her team have done an amazing job of accommodating those requests. So thank you, parents, for your patience. Really appreciate it.
Absolutely.
I have one question. So when do the quarantine kids join the online class too?
No, they do not.
Okay, got it.
And there's a, like, there's a, it's a, there's more there's more technical stuff. It's more of a technical school issue that because there's just, it's too much transferring of kids back and forth digitally that causes that kind of an issue as well.
Yeah, we talked about it, but we want a high quality online academy for our parents and students that are in that program. And that relationship is key, and having kids come and go is not in the best interest of anyone. So each individual school will be working with us in curriculum instruction to set up the Canvas options for parents with their assigned teachers. Should a quarantine classroom take place, and we've had a couple, unfortunately, crop up. So hopefully we're on the downhill side of quarantining COVID cases.
Estaban hablando, una de las preguntas que querían saber, que estaban curiosos, de la cantidad de niños que recibieron en este año escolar, que si era algo sorprendente, algo que no esperaban. Habían dicho que, por supuesto, era algo demasiado, pero que les agradece su paciencia de poder acumular y juntar. No esperaban tanta cantidad, porque muchos se esperaron hasta el último para registrarse. Dio, por ejemplo, que ahorita de un primer grado al sexto han tenido alrededor de 175 estudiantes en línea. Por ejemplo, en el primer grado hay 6, en el segundo grado había alrededor de 26, tercer 20, al quinto y sexto, quinto tenía alrededor casi de 30, el sexto tiene alrededor de más de 40 estudiantes. No tengo toda la información de todas las clases, pero eso fue lo que dijeron. Dijo que esperan más adelante mandarles un informatorio, un cuestionario, donde les van a preguntar sugerencias de los papás, cómo podemos mejorar este sistema en línea. Pero gracias que al equipo de la escuela, que han hecho un muy buen trabajo para poder trabajar con todas las cosas que han pasado últimamente. Al último preguntaron que si los niños que están en cuarentena están en la escuela en línea. Dijo que no. Y dijo que si ustedes deciden más adelante en el siguiente semestre de regresar a la escuela en persona, que ellos van a trabajar con usted y con los maestros para poder hacer esa transición más fácil.
Again, I'd just like to take this opportunity to thank all parents for attending today. Your participation and active involvement in your child's education, particularly in the online academy, is paramount. It's essential. And thank you, each and every one of you, for taking the time. We know that some parents are working right now. And so, again, that's the reason for the recording. And Ms. Senger will go ahead and post that to our website. Again, thank you.
Nuevamente quiero decirles gracias, más que nada gracias a los papás, por tomar el tiempo de estar aquí hoy. El hecho de que grabamos esta junta hoy es porque sabemos que muchos papás están trabajando. Entonces, más adelante vamos a tratar de poner lo que grabamos hoy en nuestra página para que los demás lo puedan ver después. Thank you. Gracias, hijo.
Yes, thank you so much. And if you have questions, please feel free to reach out or to talk with your child's teacher. And they're looking forward to being able to talk to you about your child at their conferences next week. So unless you have any other questions, you are free to go. Thank you so much for sticking out with us.
Muchas gracias por su paciencia estar aquí con nosotros hoy. Si tienen algunas preguntas, las pueden seguir haciendo ahorita o se pueden comunicar directamente con los maestros. También pueden hacer sus preguntas en las conferencias que vienen la próxima semana.